take my heart for you.
Uncle to uncle.
Can't take my eyes off you.
Uncle to uncle.
Welcome everybody to Uncle, the first podcast to record from a king-size bed. I believe we are about on day 16, 17. It's Uncle Howard's favorite winger song, actually. I am your host, Franklin, your main host, the headliner, the showstopper, the marquee, Big Uncle Franklin, Little Uncle Franklin. And I'm joined by the coolest uncle of my whole world, I guess, Uncle Howard.
Here I go again, Frank. What's my weakness? Feet. Okay, then, chillin'. I'm making my podcast. Yo, Frank, I looked around and everyone was socially isolated.
Yeah, I swear, I stand. My uncle, my witness, the brother had it going out with something kind of wicked. That's the ticket. I'm not shy, so I asked for the digits. The ho no, that don't make me. Yeah, all right. Welcome to Uncle to Uncle. We're in the king-size bed, the bed me and my uncle sleep in every single night, because we're a pair of Rhonda Shears. We're a couple of Queen of Hearts if you're playing poker, because we're up all night.
All night. Oh, man. You know who the Queen of Hearts to me was? Mary Hart, host of Entertainment Tonight.
That's right. I remember when The Rock was being interviewed by her for WrestleMania 14, and he said, "Sweetie, if The Rock was a jury, he'd be a hung one." Very insulting. What a terrible human being. You know? Do you believe he said that? He's laughing right now.
I'll never forget when he faced Mick Foley in the halftime heat match in the empty arena, and he took a bite of salsa, and then he said, "Mild!" and spit it out. It was so ungrateful of him.
Wow. It's not like he bought it. It's not like he purchased it or does any consideration for catering.
Services is what they call them.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, that's in the biz. Franklin, we got to be a little smarter about the biz, you know?
We do. The numbers are down.
Nothing's up. That's for sure.
OnlyFans subscriptions are way up. Podcast listens are way down.
What is that? People would rather jerk it than listen to a couple guys joke around for an hour and a half?
A couple of mid-30-something-year-old guys,
nitwit morons.
It shocks me. It legitimately shocks me.
It does shock me. I thought we were going to be getting that that coronavirus moolah, but instead we're just getting the coronavirus boo-sad.
They're social distancing their ears from us, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's almost like the economy just completely fell apart. I don't know what that means, do you?
I know what the economy is. Well, we have traditions. I can't go into that right now.
You're right. What is this, Planet Money? No.
Look, I watched Jim Cramer a lot during the summer 2006.
I watched Iron Man 1 and Jim Cramer's in that.
He was in that.
What's a weapons company that doesn't sell weapons?
Well, man, so we've come to the conclusion. The greatest movies are the ones of Iron Man.
Yeah. Iron Man 1, 2, and 3.
1, 2, 3, Avengers, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there 5? Yeah. I don't even know.
Well, he was in Captain America 3.
Civil War.
And he was in Spider-Man Homecoming.
Right. And he's in so many movies. He loves the movies.
He was in Dr. Doolittle.
Iron Man wasn't Dr. Doolittle. Speaking of which, you know, I can't make that announcement here. I'll tell you after the show, actually. But a lot of people might bear witness to Dr. Doolittle. It might be available free soon. I don't know. Don't listen to me. I don't know what I'm talking about here.
Interesting.
Yeah. But anyways, I could talk again about money and economy.
Yeah. Yeah, we could all day. I mean, we all, I mean, I don't even like to talk about the American economy anymore. I like to talk about economy in, like, you know, Venezuela, for example.
Something I know even more about.
Yeah.
If I know so much about the American economy, imagine what I know about the Venezuela economy.
Yeah. American economy is kind of trite at this point, I think. It's it doesn't impress anybody.
You know what they call the Dow Jones over there?
A Baja Jones?
That's right. Yeah.
Is that right?
That's correct, actually. I didn't know you knew, but as a fellow economy expert, of course you knew.
Yeah, well, I mean, I told you, I love the stock market. Instead of the New York Stock Exchange, they have the Venezuela City Stock Exchange.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Yeah.
Nonetheless, everybody, we have traditions in the king-size bed. Me and my uncle, we love to watch movies, don't we? We just love to plop down and watch a few movies and go to sleep at around 3, 4 a.m., and then our bosses yell at us when we're late to work. I mean, I don't know what that's about. They got to chill a little bit.
We love movies.
Now, I heard, I hope he doesn't show up, but one of Gold Member's cousins might show up here. And I'm not talking about Pugue Member either. I'm talking about Drug Member.
Oh, no.
I know.
That's a bad guy.
Guess what he loves?
Tell me.
I'll tell you myself.
Oh, no, Drug Member.
Drugs.
Drug Member, you're a bad influence on this household. Oh, listen to you coughing up a storm.
I've been smoking a cigar. Do you have any more drugs?
I've only got a bong and a blintz for you, my friend.
Well, I am not difficult to please. Please hand it over.
Okay. Wow, that was a really good bong.
Good drugs. I must go.
That's a sick bong, Drug Member.
Kai. Well, Drug Member, don't come back. You and Pugue Member. You and your perverted. She was Zach Braff, all right?
Yeah. Oh, she was big time.
God. Is Zach Braff Pugue Member?
I love Scrubs.
No. Oh man,
can you imagine if a Gold Member had been in Garden State though? I love Shins.
Oh God, man, it changes life, didn't it?
Okay.
You know, I've never seen Garden State. I have seen Elizabeth Town, which is like the fake Garden State.
Yeah.
Orlando Bloom and Kirsten Dunst.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear it. You saw 500 Days of Summer. That's Garden State, too, isn't it?
I guess, but they have more indie animations and laurels. They have the rural laurels.
Oh, the rural lore starring Alex Ferrer.
Yep. You know, one day he's going to listen to the show and be like, oh, so
what
I'm
the fuck, guys? I'm a joke to you?
My last name's not that fucking difficult, clowns. Gonna get business.
I still can't say the former mayor of New York's name.
No, you cannot.
Giuliani.
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 Yeah, you got it.
I thought it was Giuliani.
I have a tough time with this Cummo guy.
Oh yeah,
Cummo.
Mario Cuomo.
Cuomo. Yeah, Cuomo. I don't. He's got a nipple piercing, apparently.
I don't do this New York stuff, my brother.
Yeah, I guess not. Movies. What about them? We watched them. We absolutely loved them. And I saw a movie just the other day. I've never seen this movie before. Maybe you've seen it.
Yeah.
It's from 2001. A few months, you know, before.
Yeah.
And it's one word. The movie is one word. Can you believe that for starters? It's one word. Blow.
Oh, baby.
Blow.
That's sexy.
Starring Ethan Suplee and John Depp.
Joe, that old bag of bones.
No way, he was young there, so he's Johnny, baby.
I can't wait for when he becomes a distinguished actor. It's Jonathan Depp.
The final. Do you remember when Joey Lawrence changed to Joseph?
Joseph Lawrence.
But then he had the walk of shame because he's like, he was getting less work. So he's like, no, look, fine. I'm Joey again. I'm a toddler. Fine. Yeah, I don't care. Yeah. I don't care.
Mommy.
Yeah. It's like little Romeo tried to be Romeo.
Yeah, that's right.
And Bow Wow was just like, I don't give a fuck what you call me. Call me little Bow Wow. What the fuck? That's what you guys know me as, you know? And what happened? He went to Tokyo Drift.
That's right. I was just about to say everything worked out good for him.
Yeah, not so good for Romeo.
Yeah, whither art thou, Romeo?
With Master P running House of Glory over in New York.
Yeah, yeah, great promotion. Yeah. Hey, we're really maintaining our ability to not alienate our fans.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, look, you got a Joey Lawrence, a Jonathan Depp. I mean, Johnny Depp's a heartthrob still, right? They still have him in posters in colleges.
Yeah, yeah.
Uni.
Yeah, uni, drinking that bottle of James Beam.
Mm-hmm. So this movie, Blow, I guess there's a thing in the early 2000s, late 90s, where people thought these movies that, you know, if you were going to think, I'm like, oh, I don't care about drugs, or I don't think drugs, I think drugs are very cool. I think drugs are great. I think they're fantastic.
Yeah.
However, you give me some movie of John
Stephen
Depp.
Stephen A. Smith?
You give me some movie of John Depp talking about how he made all this money and how drugs are great. It kind of loses it. It kind of is like, you know what? Drugs aren't that cool after all. If Johnny Depp's talking about how much he did them, how much money. I mean, I don't need a rags to riches to behind bars story. It was a fine movie, Blow. I like Ethan Suplee. His character just disappears at some point. We don't hear what happens, but you know who else is in this big unk?
Who's that?
Paul Rubens.
Pee-wee Herman himself?
Pee-wee Herman plays a big part in this film.
Oh, now that's cool.
And he was the saving grace of this movie. I have to say, Pee-wee Herman, best part about Blow, 2001. Best part.
I am not shocked to hear that.
No. So go watch it. It's okay. It's okay. It's a little tacky, but it's okay.
The thing about all these drug movies, every single one, they go, oh, he's living the high life of drugs, and it shows him and he's partying on the beach with babes around and spending a lot of money like it's nothing, and then they're like, oh, the low point of drugs, and it shows him, and the camera's always using like a fluorescent lighting or something, so it looks extra crappy, and he's sweating, and then he goes to jail.
You know,
why aren't there any drug movies where a guy just has a great time on drugs?
Right? Why does it have to be consequences all the time?
Yeah. Jay, if they weren't fun, if they weren't fun, people wouldn't do them. And last I checked, you don't ruin your life because you're busy having fun riding roller skates at Disneyland. So why are drugs any different?
That's a great point. Are there any drug dealers who are just like, they're rich, they're making a ton of money, but they still can't get babes over to their pool? Because I kind of fear that would be me as a drug dealer. I kind of fear, like, hey, I'm a millionaire. What's wrong with you? Why don't you want to go to my pool? There's nobody partying here. I'm a fucking millionaire. Why am I still a loser?
They'd say, oh, those other drug dealers have a pet orangutans or something like that.
God, I would need to get into the exotic animal business just to get interesting.
You would, probably. Something like that. You need some sort of hook. Maybe
you need a hook?
You need a hook as a drug.
Yeah. Are drugs not enough anymore?
No, look at El Chapo. He was, he had a podcast, so that was kind of his thing.
I've never heard, and I'm not trying to be contrarian, I'm sure it's fine. I mean, the guys are very nice in the few interactions I've had with them on my other accounts. They've been very nice to me. However, I'd never heard their show, and I just assume it's about 30 white guys talking on a podcast. It's like Doug Funny's band.
It's if you want Jack Allison's Twitter account in slow motion, I think you listen to their show.
Jeez, I love Jack. I love Jack.
Yeah,
I don't need four or five Jacks.
My favorite thing about Jack isn't so much his viewpoint, but his relentless chaos. And I just don't think you can get that same chaos from a podcast as opposed to Jack actively fighting with some guy you've never heard of before.
That are apparently, yeah, I don't know. I would never heard of Pod Save America if it wasn't for Jack.
Yeah, if I even had learned about that on my own, I'd be mad that it got in my brain.
Anyways. Oh, what's your movie?
Well, thank you for asking. This movie also has a single word in the title.
Okay, can I guess?
Yeah.
I already know what it is. Spear. Boom. Thank you. Jackpot.
Spear?
Okay, fine. Can I get another guess?
Yeah, one more.
Madea. Yeah, one of the best movies. It's a high grosser.
Madea 1.
Madea 1. That's it. No Roman numeral, my brother.
No, yeah, this was the one that started it all. This movie features an actor who looks an awful lot like Jeremy Renner. Also, in this movie is my favorite actor, Johnny Legs, John Leguizamo. This is a Neville Dean / Taylor directing film, and I know you like movies where they're directed by someone with a hip name, kind of an unusual sobriquet. Well, this is the team of Mark Neville Dean and Brian Taylor, but they just call themselves Neville Dean / Taylor. This movie's This movie's called Gamer Franklin.
It is. Ooh, Frankie Muniz?
No. That's that other one that I think I've already picked, where they play the video game that kills them.
Yeah. Bugman talked about it.
Yeah, this movie is Gerard Butler is in a video game where he's controlled by people, and if you survive, you don't have to be in prison anymore. But the game is weighted against you, so you can never win, and he's controlled by some little nerd, and Kira Sedgwick is in it, and Terry Crews is in it. It's really weird. There's a part where his wife is also being controlled in a video game, but instead of being in a murder game, she's in sort of a sexy Second Life game, and she's being controlled by this very, very big boy, and the big boy always sensually rubs his big boy belly, and it made me wonder, does that feel different for big boys than for smaller boys? Because I don't ever feel aroused or very satisfied in some way, and I rub my belly. Do you ever do that, Franklin?
I've tried it all. I've tried it all.
Rubbing backwards.
Backwards. All the positions, for starters. But that's neither here nor there. You know, you try choking yourself. You try spanking your own bottom.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, you need somebody else to do that for you. I can't get into a movie if I see that. Because then I think, they're lying. You don't get off by rubbing your own nips.
Big belly.
Yeah, I don't buy that. I'm sorry. Not by a long shot.
Do you think people do it, though? You don't think anybody is out there?
Yeah, I think people do it. I think people do it, but they're lying to themselves, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. They're not really getting off. They're pretending to get off.
You believe belly rubbing is a thing people do.
Oh, belly rubbing?
Yeah, he's a big fat guy, and he's rubbing his own tummy. Like, this lady video game is getting all naked. I better rub my big boy belly here.
Yeah, because you see it enough in movies, I guess.
Yum yum, right?
I don't know. This is disturbing for me.
Well, it was a disturbing scene because he's making this lady do Second Life things, but in real life she is real. But then everybody is happy in the end. The main villain's played by the guy who plays Dexter.
Castor Troy.
Yes, the villainous Castor Troy.
So Dexter's in. I've never seen Dexter.
I haven't either, but I thought he was an appealing enough actor in this movie, I suppose. I would say this movie's worth watching. It is also a short film, so you don't waste a lot of time. It's about 95 minutes, which is still a little bit too long, but nonetheless, there you have it. Oh, I forgot to tell you that since no one's ever going to watch this movie, I'm just going to tell you the best part is that there's a anti-video, this villain who made all of this, it's called The Society, and I thought, is this what people on the internet are talking about when they say we live in a society? Are they referencing this movie? I don't know.
I don't know.
I truly don't know.
Is that what George Costanza was referencing?
Yeah, I think so.
We live in a society.
Yeah. But there's a anti-society pro-human league called the Humans with a Z at the end. And the Humans are helmed by none other than Chris Ludacris Bridges.
Wow. Okay. Chris Ludacris Bridges in this movie. You wait so long to drop that bombshell on me.
I wanted to get you intrigued and trenched.
Tej from Fast and Furious.
You know, you think he's just a little computer geek nerd, but he can handle himself in a fight, too.
Well, apparently he was a mechanic in Too Fast, Too Furious.
Yeah, but then
no,
he becomes
no acknowledgement of his hacker knowledge whatsoever. He, not even a throwaway line. Well, if you know your way around the car, a computer is nothing.
Yeah.
That'd be a good line.
Computer and a car, they're not so different.
They're not so different. They both got a motherboard, and they both go fast.
You gotta know when to step on the gas, and you gotta know when to floor it.
One's got RAM, one's got an engine. Ain't no difference.
One's got RAM, and one'll ram down the gates to this bank that we're robbing.
We're really adding some depth to the Tej character.
Yeah.
He's a philanthropist, you know, in the movie. He rigs an ATM.
Yeah,
and all that money goes out. Yeah.
He's like, forget where you came from, or something.
Yeah. And then Roman gets in.
Roman's plane that says, it's Roman bitch.
Roman
time.
It's Roman bitch. That guy Roman.
He's a jokester. What a clown.
It's amazing he hasn't lost all his money, to be honest.
Yeah, well, he just keeps making money left and right. And he's a coward, so in that regard, he's probably smart with his money.
You know what? We don't speak enough about that. We don't speak enough about the Fast and the Furious movies. That's why our numbers are so low. They say, you know what? Make me listen to these two guys, both relatively white in their 30s, if they spoke about this franchise enough.
Something? I was thinking today how there are some movie franchises that we talk about so much that we can never pick them as our movies of the night. The Marvel films, Star Wars, and Fast and Furious are
The best there, man.
They're the best movies, and we never pick them as a movie of the night.
I love those movies.
I literally love them all so much.
They're so good, and you know what? They've always been there for you when your friends haven't.
Yeah, I just rewatched Iron Man 1. That's how I knew about Jim Cramer being in there, and I had a great time watching it, man.
He saw it on USA not too long ago.
Yeah, man, he has the Jericho missile, and it's so cool. And then he's got all of his drinks in the refrigerated briefcase, and that's so cool.
And he says, "Don't put this on MySpace."
Yeah, MySpace. Yeah. And he says, "Oh, I'm just kidding. You can." Because he's a cool guy, man.
He's pretty chill.
He's so chill.
It's amazing how his character is probably the only one in the whole Marvel Cinematic Universe that gets worse. I like him so much less as time progresses.
Yeah,
and then he becomes a father, and it's like, ugh.
It's up to me to save the day.
Ugh, that's terrible.
You just gotta get drunk with DJ AM, man.
Yeah, he's still alive in that universe.
Yeah, we never see DJ AM die in Marvel.
DJ AM snapped. Oh, Lord.
Rest in peace.
Well, rest in peace, for sure. You know, another thing I want to bring about drug movies.
Mm.
You know when the down point normally is?
When?
When they have kids.
Oh,
yeah. The fucking single life is terrific, or like just fucking, not even single life, just, you know, just.
The party life.
The party life. And then, then I had a kid. Like, oh, so this is when things go wrong for you. Duly noted.
Yeah. You know what, Franklin? It doesn't make sense that people aren't just always on drugs or drunk. Because it's so much fun to be drunk, right?
Oh, it's the best. I mean, I don't know much about that. I'm not too much of a drinker, personally.
Yeah, we don't do the drapers, my brother. But
no, Drake. This is like we're sober now, man.
Sober as a judge. Why don't we just always drink Mike's Hard Lemonades? Why don't I wake up? Why am I ever drinking dirty old Diet Pepsis when I could be just putting down the Mike's Hard?
What's that clear stuff that comes out of our sink? I can't stand it.
Oh, I don't. That's the stuff when I return it. When I return the bottles of vodka to the grocery store, and I say this one's defective. I fill it up with that weird white stuff.
I hate that stuff.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
I really do. You know, yeah. I'm not a fan.
If I ever have to drink it, I dissolve about twice as much Crystal Light as needed in one of them. That's the lie, my brother.
Water, just toss in a couple of Crystal Lights and you're good. It's not as bad. You can suck them down easier.
Yeah, there's caffeine in some of them Crystal Lights. So at least there's a purpose to drinking that dumbass water. I just want to drink something that doesn't wake me up or get me drunk. That's stupid.
Yeah, what the fuck, right? Those are the only two. So, have you ever tried that Mio stuff?
I don't really like the Mio, my brother.
Now, I mixed it with a Corona once, and it was pretty good.
Oh, hey, now. Mm-hmm. Hey, Corona, pal.
Do you have the questions prepped?
I got the questions prepped, my brother.
Okay, you know, now you're really sounding like him. You sound like tie-dye guy when you're that high pitch.
Is that how he does it? I don't do YouTube, my brother. like that?
Yeah, a little bit, man. You know, he was riding on the train after the AEW show. Thought he had a pop rod. No, I thought he had a pop
Come
rod.
Ride
He's taking
the train.
I hope somebody took his glasses from him. He looks silly.
He's a cool guy, man. No, he's wearing his tie-dye.
Yeah. Do you imagine if some streetwise guys see this guy in a Hulk Hogan shirt? This 50-year-old man.
They'd be like, "Whoa, that guy's cool."
Yeah, that's exactly how that interact. Hey, buddy, cool shirt.
Hey, man, like your style.
Thanks, my brother. Hulk Hogan, he's one of the best.
Hulk Hogan for life, my brother.
Just slap me some skin.
You're a real hip cat. All right. So what makes us are the fans, though. We eat the meat before we have our pudding, Franklin. That's that Ben Floyd.
Oh no! Oh no! Is that fan member coming through the door? Oh no!
Hey, fan member.
I love your fans.
Whoa,
is Teach there? Isn't that weird?
He's from Chicago, isn't that weird?
Oh, deep dish. All right, my fan member. All
right.
That family. They moved next door just a few weeks ago. Terrible.
Deep dish in a jarum.
Yeah. No thanks, actually.
That's dreadful.
I hate deep dish pizza.
Really?
I don't hate it. It's fine. You eat pizza. I love any kind of pizza. But the idea is, it's just more. Congratulations. Oh, you figured out the perfect recipe. More. It's like when somebody says, "Oh, I want a threesome with these babes," and somebody goes, "Oh, I want a foursome with another babe in there." Like, you know what? That's too much, my brother. That's too much.
Isn't that just typical American excess and consumption? That's what got us into this whole mess in the first place.
Man, that's one of the smartest things you have ever said on this show.
People would rather have one huge pizza instead of two Sparrows. I mean, do the math, people.
You know what Jeremy Seville said?
What? He's a funny man.
Yeah, he is. Fuck. He says the prime minister in the UK has banned gatherings of more of two people. This is the first outlawing of threesomes.
Jeremy Seville.
Zero likes.
What is Jeremy Seville up to? What is his plan?
Jeremy Seville, what's your exit strategy here? What is your game plan for fame? Yeah. Because it's not working for the director of Loquisha. Did he not have a plan for life after Loquisha?
I've been reading some stuff lately that said Joe Biden's fucking up and they might get him out of here and replace him with someone new. And I'm saying Jeremy Seville's right there.
Being replaced or being the guy who replaces Biden?
He's going to replace Biden. They're going to say Biden's out, Seville's in, his running mate's Bloomberg. You've got two votes guaranteed.
That's them.
Oh, God. Why aren't they trying to get the uncle vote with a Seville Bloomberg ticket?
Why is the uncle vote being so neglected right now?
This is absurd.
They don't care about an endorsement.
No, no. I haven't heard anyone specifically speak to uncles in this campaign. Not even my close personal friend Donald.
No, wow, right? That's a little much. That's a little much. Maybe that'll change. So give him a chance.
Yeah, he's always been good to the uncle community. At least in, you know, you can always count on him to vote in our interest, even
he
if
seems
you
so
talk about it.
He seems so furious at the fact that he has to, like, work for the first time in all this. And he's just getting madder and madder, and he keeps changing his game plan. Yeah. And it's just like, what do you want me to do? I'm working every day. I hate this so much. I'm giving you ratings. He's getting so mad. I don't feel for him because he's a terrible person. At the end of the day,
that's my friend. Show some respect.
I respect that he's your friend, but you have to respect the fact that I think he is terrible. You know.
I do. I respect that my friend hates my other friend.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Well,
You know, he's having a very bad time lately, and I think because most everything else he's ever had to deal with, it's been the kind of thing where you just say you're dealing with it until it's gone. You know,
to be fair, I love those things.
I know, I'm a fan of the way he not as a president should act, but I was gonna say in his personal life, I respect. I don't like that even less. Yeah, but I like the strategy behind it, though, where you just basically just say things are happening the way you want them to until they really are. I realize that's also a bad viewpoint in a lot of ways. So
he's not good at what he does necessarily, but as somebody who's incompetent in some form, you know, incompetence can recognize incompetence.
I see a true loafer in him, I guess. He's if he had to work at an ice cream shop, he would never be sweeping up the floors on his free time.
No.
Yeah.
How about those fans, Big Unk?
Yeah, let's hear it for them.
Don't say that. Don't say it like that. You know, I type your name into the Twitter search, and for some reason, Maitland Ward pops up first. I don't like that.
Yeah, well, I do. I know why.
Why is Nasty Boy Sags on your... Okay, I need to stop. I'm sorry, everybody.
Me, him, and Maitland Ward had a crazy night in Jacksonville.
It was Knobs. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
everybody.
Well, Brian Knobs, Jerry Sags, and Tie-Dye Guy.
Yeah. That's quite the group right there. Sleeveless shirts.
Yeah, now that's a party.
That's a lot of Florida for people to handle right there.
Yeah, that is extra Florida.
God.
Hey, but the fans, right?
Is that fan member? I mean, I see. No. Okay. I've had a few. So first question comes from Bert. Besides each other, what was the last human contact you made? Well, oddly enough, it was Jodie Foster. The star of the movie Contact. Yeah. No. Human contact... In terms, man, somebody who where I work, he always goes in for a big fucking handshake. Even up to fucking, like, I mean, this was almost 3 weeks ago, so it's not a fucking big deal. But man, like, we're hearing about this news, and you're still going in for that deep handshake, and yeah, I really spite him a little for it. So just some dork I work with, I didn't want to be rude. But, you know, as we said on the show before, it's better to be rude than to be dead. So be rude, people, be rude. People need to be ruder for self-preservation purposes.
Yeah, never mind. I was going to say something about New Yorkers and rudeness, but I realize they're not having a great time of things right now.
They're not having a great time. They're not. Maybe we should cheer them up and have our campus invasion over at Hudson University.
I love Hudson U.
I got in, you know that. I never went, but I got in.
I went to Empire State University, so I understand.
Oh, man. Well, we know this show is funny to two people.
Yeah, us. You know, I think of Fred Durst's line in the song Break Stuff by Limp Bizkit when he says, "No human contact, and if you interact, your life is on contract."
Oh, that's a good song.
Your best bet is to stay away, motherfucker. It's just one of those days.
Damn, that's a good, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that guy's cool, friend of the Undertaker, Fred Durst.
Yeah, he's rolling. He's also a friend of Travolta, a.k.a. Gotti. That's how it all ties together, Matt Pinfield.
That's how it ties together. Oh, Matt Pinfield. What a reference that the uni students love it.
Yeah, Matt Pinhead, as far as I'm concerned.
God. Man, imagine if we were funnier to younger people, though, Uncle Howard. I'm telling you. I'm telling you.
All right, we got to get a little funnier to
how about we
people.
Reference who's Kendrick Lamar? That's a guy.
He's a raps man.
He's a rapsman.
Yeah, he loves to do his rappings.
We talk about Marvel movies. I don't see the fucking point, man.
Those are hip. Who told you we're not hip enough for
I don't
youth?
Know. I'm kind of feeling insecure lately. Like that, our audience is so old. Cause you know who
They're
I
so
met the other day?
Old
member. No, not old member.
I'm so old.
Old member, why'd you drag over here? You know there's social distancing.
Oh, I'm not afraid of coronavirus. Isn't that weird?
It's more than weird. It's a little disrespectful.
All right, bye.
Bye, old member. I they just moved down the block. I can't stand them.
There goes the neighborhood. You have one member move in, and the next thing you know, it's nothing but members all over.
I miss the general. I miss our season one. I miss Dr. Marvin Monroe. I had Lady Gubbs Murphy. I miss all of our season oneers. I don't like where we're going. I like the illusion of season one where people have some posters. I just want a poster. That's like the conclusion I've come to there, in this, Uncle Howard.
Yeah,
I want a poster.
We're going to make a poster.
And somebody needs to hang it up in their dorm, and maybe I'll feel a little more secure.
There's got to be some dorm people out there, right? If you live in a dorm, hit up BugTV Franklin on Twitter and say, hashtag dormhead.
Dormhead, you'll get a
Dormammu.
Dorm, who else? He lives in quite the dorm. The dorm of stars. Moving on.
What is this?
What is this? It's a poster for your room. Okay, I've evolved past rooms.
Why was Dormammu so mad?
He needs a nut.
Yeah.
Dormammu, just nut, bro.
Didn't we determine he doesn't have a dick, so...
He just has celestial gas.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's probably that's the seventh sex position.
The seventh sex position.
The seventh can only be done by Dormammu, but it exists.
You're going to read the next question, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I sure do. All right, this is a question. This is a first-time asker from Head and Arm Choke. At Head and Arm Choke. He's a professional wrestler. That's pretty
cool. Whoa. We got a real pro wrestler in the fucking...
We got a couple wrestlers.
The boys in the
one,
back?
My brother. Yeah, boys in the good brothers.
The good brothers. Hey. Yeah. I'll give that man a limp handshake any day, my brother.
We better not go to wrestler's court with these guys.
No.
There's some tough
is
brothers.
Is he a wrestler? I'm looking at his page.
He's post-wrestling. He's that little fella in the circle there doing a suplex onto the mat.
Okay. Okay, yeah, doesn't look like a ring, though. I'm sorry, but that does not look like a ring.
Yeah, they don't use rings in Gato Move either, but that's wrestling.
That's true, and that's perverts, too.
Yeah, well, I never said this guy wasn't a pervert, because look at this question. He says, who are your top five babes to be stuck in quarantine with?
That's sorry, I'm watching Inoki videos on this. Top five babes. I'm hung up on this Inoki video that he's posted here.
I would go with Inoki. I want a strong man in there to wrestle with.
Man, I should have prepared for these questions because there's avenues to go, and then there's just like the horny avenue, and I don't want to go on that route. I want to be less horny on this show. And
Franklin, mm-hmm. think about this way: what do you do when you put together a team?
You get somebody. You get equal representation. You get someone who helps in every avenue.
Yeah. So why don't you think of it that way?
Okay, so funniness. Oh man, I mean, who is funnier than Pam Anderson? Nobody.
That's right. Nobody. Barwire, what a riot.
And Joey Heatherton. That's just another. Look, I'm assembling my own team here. I want a team that's very optimistic, very perky. Okay?
Yeah, definitely. Okay.
You know? Yeah. How about you do your team? Let me think about mine. You know, I need a moment. I'm sorry.
I thought of it a little differently, because he never said babes had to be lady babes.
I was gonna mention some Hemsworths at some point.
I would say Captain America, Star-Lord,
no.
Thor,
no.
Rocket Raccoon.
Okay.
That's and four. Agent Colby Coulson? Smulders.
Colby Smulders. That's my favorite Avenger.
Yeah, she's a great Avenger.
The best Avenger right there, Colby Smulders.
She's like, hey, sir, they're getting away.
How'd you meet her?
How'd I meet Colby Smulders?
How'd you meet Colby Smulders?
I was drinking at this bar with this incredibly young doctor. He was like a 14-year-old doctor, but he was bragging all the time about women. And we were hanging out at this bar, and she came by with this evil witch from Southern California. And that tall guy who's weird looking.
I believe you were also with Jim's wife from American Pie.
Yeah, that's the evil witch from Southern California.
I don't know. I don't watch Buffy or whatever the fuck.
Oh, brother.
I'm sorry.
No, you're missing out on some numero uno.
Look,
babes.
There's things you just, if you're late to it, you're late to it. Are you tell somebody, like, hey, go, you gotta watch it? No. Oh,
hey,
you're 40? You gotta watch American Pie right now. It's so good.
Yeah, I definitely would tell somebody that.
No, I would not. You missed the boat on things, man. Are you gonna tell somebody you gotta go back and watch Game of Thrones? No,
of course not. But I mean, if somebody said, oh, I've never eaten an apple before, I'd say, well, that's wild. You should probably try one just to know what it's like. The same thing with American Pie, because American Pie is made with apples, my brother.
You had to turn it around on me with science. Man. Let me tell you, I can't answer this question because I'm too horny of a person to give you an answer that's almost disrespectful. I'm sorry.
I'll tell you the classes, and you tell me what babe would be best in that class for quarantine.
Okay. Please.
Sniper.
A sniper? Somebody, a sharp shooter? Well, I guess, see, I'm still too horny. So it's when I think a sniper, they got to be wearing leather. And I think leather, you think I'm thinking
Anderson and barbed wire.
I'm thinking Pam Anderson and barbed wire, man. I'm sorry. You know, fine. Fine. Scarlett Johansson, I suppose. She wears leather too, though.
Yeah, she does. All right. God. Then you got to have the hand-to-hand tactical expert.
I don't like how you're saying hand-to-hand. You're still making me horny.
Stop.
Somebody good with their hands. Oh, Lord.
Yeah.
Oh, God. So a tactical expert here. Well, I mean, do they get any more tactical and a few moves ahead than Salt, Angie Jolly, Angelina Voigt?
Salt.
Salt, baby. You're not a fan of the Salt verse?
Do you think Salt would beat Anna or Red Sparrow?
That's a fantastic question.
Yeah. Or Black Widow versus Red Sparrow. That's the movie I want to see.
Yeah. Smart film.
Oh, that Pug member would be there for that.
Pug member, oh yeah, star of the movie that will not be released.
Yeah, it got caught and compromised.
It got Black Widow will be the I Am Legend Batman versus Superman poster in the background of our future.
Oh, tragic. Anyway, So I okay. There's more. Then there's you gotta have the talker, the one who can charm people.
Well, that has to be Jennifer Lawrence from Silver Linings Playbook.
Yeah, she's pretty charming in that.
She's pretty charming in that movie. Yeah. I felt that was the only version of Jennifer Lawrence that was like, you know what? That one I have a chance with.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah. Like, that one I have a chance with. The others, not so much. The other are too prominent and successful. That one's kind of a loser. Yeah. Staying with a guy who jocks with a trash bag on, get behind.
Hey, that guy is one of the greatest geniuses of all time, my brother.
That was later, my brother.
Oh, that's right. She was also kind of a loser in American Hustle. All right, but yeah, she's the charmer. Then let's see, you got to have the driver.
The driver, again, that goes back to one person who's gone in 60 seconds, Angelina Voigt.
That movie's so good.
She has dreads in that one.
Yeah, blonde dreads.
Very, very tasteful.
Yeah, and then she does a little kissy face. All right, I think you need one more, right?
God.
You need the heavy gunnery person. The big time blaster.
Okay.
Person.
Oh well. Oh man, that's tough right there. A heavy gunner. Somebody. Well, that's easy then. Gina Carano right there.
Yeah.
Gina Carano. There we go.
See, my brother, you and I got there together.
These are still relatively picks based on horniness.
Well, I mean, the guy didn't say who are your top five babes to be stuck in quarantine with to talk about Venezuela's economy.
Well, if that was the case, it would still...
Then my answer would be Gina Carano.
Gina Carano. You know, yes, Angelina Voigt is very, very... She's a little close to being conservative.
Yeah,
despite hating her pappy, you know, and swearing she wouldn't become anything like John Voigt.
The apple don't fall far from the tree, honey. Mm.
What are we, two questions in? We gotta...
Yeah, we're doing great.
This guy, right, you know, you got a lot of bang for your first timer. You got a lot of bang for that question right there, man. I hope you appreciated the thought put into that.
Yeah, that was a good question, man.
It was a fantastic question. But you see, the problem with that question is you're just trying to make me horny, and I don't appreciate that. Not when I'm recording. I'm a professional.
Yeah, we're in the same bed, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, really think about that next time you ask a question.
Respect, head and arm choke. All right, you want to ask the next one here, little lunk?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
The next one comes from Jenny. She's asking, is it true that Uncle Howard was once on an episode of Double Dare Family Edition with his ex-family? Well.
I don't like to talk about, because as far as I'm concerned, little Unc, I've only got one family, and it's you. And I never look back. You know that about me. It's like what Flava Flav said after Pumpkin sped on New York when he said, "What she did was whack, but we always look forward and we never go back."
He said that, really?
Yeah, he sure did, man. I remember.
Do they have a Pluto channel? I don't know. We'll talk about that.
Fuck. I don't know. We gotta talk about that later, apparently.
Yeah, there's a
couple. Yeah. I used to hang out with a couple of this family. There was the dad of the family was named Charles. And then there was the mommy named Squeaky. And there was a guy named Tex hanging around. And I don't know. There were some other ladies. It was a long time ago. And
Charles? Squeaky,
yeah.
Was Beast there? Is this the X-Men?
Yeah, Beast was there.
Kelsey
Grammer was there. We were in the danger room all the time, so we were always taking the physical challenges.
Man.
Yeah, dare, double dare, physical.
Who got
challenge.
The nose? That one was difficult. You gotta stick your hand
the
up that
big
nose.
Snotty nose and pull
and get
out
that flag.
God, that's
that was
right.
Tough. The nose. Yeah. The nose was the silver monkey of double dare.
You know who would do that? Who had the most Toad would stick go up there with his tongue. But then the opposite team had this girl, and she said, "You know what happens to a toad that gets hit by lightning and electrified him?"
No. Whoa.
Yeah, shocks bad him. Time. Yeah. It got out of hand. And that's why I don't talk to them no more at all.
You don't talk to your ex-family, huh?
No, my ex-family. Especially because one of them's bald as hell.
You didn't have to go that route.
No. Hey, you know, it occurred to me, let's take a break in the middle of these questions to do our advertisement, which we'll just kind of recite from rough memory.
Mm-hmm. Let me recite it right now. I'm not going to go piss. Let me and recite it right now. Friday, 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 this Friday, coming to a stream near you, Shakey's Hog. You have been waiting for this moment, and now it's coming. This Friday at 7 p.m. on the Bazizio Gaming Channel, only on Twitch. Is it crooked? Is it big? Is it teeny? Is it tiny? Is it skinny? Come find out. Only on the Bazizio Gaming Channel. On Twitch, 7 p.m. Friday. Shakey's Hog.
I like Shaky Bakey enough. I like him enough that I'm not going to analyze his dick.
Well, I'm not going to
I won't
judge it in public, but I'm still going to analyze and pay close attention to it. Why wouldn't
I? Are you? I mean, I guess yeah. I'd pay attention, but I wouldn't even think a judgmental thought. I would just kind of feel like, there it is. You know, like when you look at a rare bird and you say, oh, I get why people like that.
It's not judgmental. I'm just gonna pay attention to it. It's if anything, it's
unbiased.
You're gonna
memorize it. You're gonna commit it to memory for later.
I had no idea you were still recording here. I'm here dropping things in the fridge. You know, I got this 24 pack of Well, not 24 pack, I got 2 12 packs of White Claw. You know, this is 2 days ago. I'm down to 10 cans here. How much
you
have you been drinking?
Hydrated, my brother.
That's true. That's smart.
You're not gonna be drinking that dirty old faucet water.
You know that water stuff, man. I am sick of tired. What's so fucking funny to you, man? God damn! I'm trying to do a show here.
I'm just thinking how I'm sick of tired of being sick of tired.
Okay, very funny. Very funny.
Yeah. Well, this is a comedy podcast. This is allegedly.
We don't need comedy member out here now.
We don't do comedy, my brother.
We don't do it. Oh, no. We don't do comedy, my brother. That's going to be the day somebody listens to my show that I know for real.
What sort of show is it? A comedy show?
We don't do that.
Yeah,
just
no,
science.
It's mostly news.
So back to Shake and Bakey's dick. I'll pay attention to texture, veininess, greasiness is a big factor as well. For some reason, some dicks look like they're perspiring quite
a
bit.
They are.
They have a nice hue, a nice glow to them. I don't understand it.
It's like a pregnant woman, but
you better hope
dick.
You don't have a... Better hope you don't have a dry dick, shaking, baking. Blue Ribbon Award winner.
Yeah, Blue Ribbon Award winner, and keep that dick wet, boy.
Yeah, get some coconut oil before you whip it out.
Yeah, whip them out Wednesdays. Coming to Twitch.
Hey, tomorrow. Hey. Today was Sleeve's favorite day. Today was Titty Tuesday.
Titty Tuesday, whip them out Wednesday. That guy's in hog heaven every single damn day. Throwback Thursday. Come on.
Flashback Friday.
Follow Friday. Yeah, Flashback
Follow
Friday.
Yeah.
I'm bringing back Follow Friday, my brothers.
Somebody's got to follow us.
Yeah, follow us.
Chris Kattan, follow us.
Yeah, let's wage war against Chris Kattan to make him follow us.
I think I have an account that has more followers than him.
We definitely could get everyone together to annoy Chris Kattan so bad.
Leave me alone!
What do you want from me? Follow this guy.
Be on our stupid-ass show.
Yeah, you won't enjoy it, but just do it.
You know the thing about Chris Kattan? I bet he's the only honest person from SNL, and that's why he was ousted.
Yeah, he was told... Well, because truth tellers are always looked down upon.
Do you think he left?
No, I don't think...
It's time. It's like the clone troopers seeing Bail Organa. Time for you to go, sir.
There's no way he was forced. They probably were on their hands and knees begging for him.
You're
going to
be a big star. Please don't go.
They said, we can't get enough of Mango.
Oh, God. Would Mango go over well today?
I don't know. Is Mango offensive?
I don't think it's offensive, but when you're talking... Ugh, we're not smart enough for this bullshit, so I'm not going to try.
Yeah, I mean, he's like a caveman, right?
I don't know. He was a caveman with a rock. Ugh, I hate that
guy. Oh, wait, no, that's right. That's a different character. Mango was the one that everyone fell in love with.
Mango, yeah, everybody was hot for Mango. Mango fever.
Yeah. I got it bad, so bad. I'm hot for Mango.
Now you got it. Great. Bobby Babylon asks, this is for me. What would Franklin do if COVID stopped all Coca-Cola manufacturers? Would he lose it without his classic Coca-Cola? Oh, I do love classic Coca-Cola. You know, I love soda pop. I love seltzer beverages, alcoholic seltzer beverages.
Oh,
I love
no.
it all.
Is seltzer member going to be coming by?
Oh, no, not seltzer member. Friend of the show.
I love bubbles.
Shit, I might turn into that guy. A couple more of these White Claws. Oof. You know what I think about a lot? Bobby, that's an excellent question. It's an excellent question. I think a lot about these Twitter leftists who want to go to war and end consumerism and capitalism, and that's fantastic. I don't disagree with the notion. Man, what are you going to do if you can't go to Walgreens and get that nice 16-ounce of Rain body fuel, huh? That's a toughie.
Yeah.
That's a tough one right there. You can't get a bag of Cheetos, some Pepsi coin, you know, some Yum Brands. I don't know. I don't know. I'm not too thrilled about certain aspects of capitalism ending. I do love snacks. Will there still be snacks is my question.
It seems like it would be boring a little bit, doesn't it? Just sitting around reading your books about Venezuela all the time. I mean, for
Lord
me, that's pretty
boring.
Lord,
we've read so many of them.
I mean, I already know an awful lot about Venezuela.
We should have Jack on the show and debate the merits of Venezuela.
Yeah, I would love to see Jack defend the situation in Venezuela.
The one we know.
We know all about. I mean, you know, we've always said we don't like what's happening in Venezuela.
Oh, no. We don't like that, my brother.
But we love the people of Venezuela.
The people matter most.
They're PMS. Almost like fans.
They're almost like the fans. Do we have a Venezuelan fan? They might think we're morons, but...
We have a fan in Argentina. Is that... That's a...
That's right in there, my brother. That's right in
the
heart.
Some people would say that's a lot like Venezuela. Other people would say it isn't. Me, I say both make good points.
Both make excellent points. The Mask Doctor, Tom Wynn, DDS. Maybe he knows Isaac Yankum.
Doctor of Dicks.
Doctor of Dick Sucking. God, that's a nice insult. It's a lovely insult for a great person. There's this lovely person who for some reason listens to our show. Hey, Doctor of Dick Sucking. Is that how you introduce yourself when you see him at BuckCon? Hey.
This guy said he was canvassing for Bernie Sanders listening to our show. Imagine him now. This poor guy is out there fighting for the common man in the world. He's a good guy and he likes our show for some reason. And we just called the doctor.
You call him the Doctor of Dick Sucking. I mean, there's nothing wrong with sucking down a couple of dicks. Axel Rotted once said, hey, it's nothing like sucking a good dick once in a while, man. Is he dead?
Axel? Yeah.
Yeah. From Guns N' Roses. Wow.
Yeah, he got caught and compromised.
Damn, Ben Laden.
By Balls Mahoney.
Balls Mahoney. God, is Balls Mahoney around?
No.
Man, these wrestlers, man. You know?
It's kind of dangerous to be a wrestler.
Kind of dangerous to be a wrestler. They're alive one day, dead the next. That don't make sense.
Yeah. No, so, I don't understand what's happening.
The Masked Doctor. He's asking, how have you boys... Sorry. I've had a lot. How have you boys been dressing in the quarantine? We still wearing underwear? I can confirm I have not worn underwear in quite a while. I went to 7-Eleven a while ago. I wore underwear then. That was over a week ago. So I have worn underwear, but man, it's been basketball shorts, and not just like basketball shorts that are well kept. Basketball shorts with the crotch starting to get blown out a bit.
Yeah. Oh, because of your 4 inches.
Those 4 inches just tear right through the fabric.
And make no mistake, everybody, that's 4 inches hard.
That's 4 inches. Yeah. Don't make a mistake like that again.
Yeah. Don't get it twisted.
That's a generous mistake. Don't do that. Legitimately, no underwear, man. Like, I mean, shit.
No.
Like, first off, is there anybody wearing denim out there? That's what I want to know. What's sick of working from home? Oh, I gotta put on my blue jeans.
My brother.
Fucking coworkers, bro. I bet the fucking Trump guy is wearing blue jeans when he fucking wakes up in the morning. God, come on, man.
My brother, I gotta make a confession to you. I dress up like I'm kind of a real person every
You're
day.
Disgusting. You are so disgusting.
I don't wear shoes. Hell no.
Ooh.
But I do.
Ooh.
I put on my pair of dungarees, and I put on a nice t-shirt, and disgusting. then I sit in this chair. And I just sit and stare at the numbers.
You sit in a chair because you're in a bed right now, but yes.
Yeah, no, well, I sit in this chair. What do I mean? Haven't you noticed that the mattress has been awfully creased in the middle lately? I've been folding it up and turning it into a chair.
Okay, I see.
I fold it like a taco, and then I'm the delicious meat within.
Oh, boy. Yeah, so to answer the good doctor's question,
what's wrong with us tonight?
I'm sorry?
I said, what's wrong with us tonight?
Well, I know what's wrong with me. I don't know if there's anything wrong with you. I feel like I'm like
probably about the same-ish thing.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not there where you are.
You're not where I am. You're not where I am because, man, I've been doing it all day. I've just been sucking these down and sucking
down those Cleveland shows.
Sucking down those Look, I'll tell you when I've had enough Cleveland show, all right? Right now I'm good. Right now I'm so good. I can recite the whole alphabet from start to finish, from A to Z.
I see a big difference in the way between how you watch Cleveland show and I watch it, because I've seen you watch 6, 7, 8 episodes in a row,
but
I can stop anytime I want.
I can stop too anytime I want. I just choose.
Let it keep playing. I don't even understand how anybody could have a problem with it. And I got plenty more to watch. This show goes on forever.
This show is so good. Look, I can stop watching the Cleveland show anytime I want. It's not a big deal. I pop it on. I watch a couple. And people say, maybe you've had enough. Nah, I'll tell you what, I've had enough and I'm good. I'm good. I can still hold a job. I have a job.
Yeah.
I have a job. I have the Cleveland show. I have my family. What else do you need to know?
And what's wrong if I want to start the day off with a little bit of an eye opener? Or have a good laugh with the Cleveland show?
I'm going to get a couple laughs in the Cleveland show during the day. It'll be our little secret. Nobody has to know. So we're moving on here. Good doctor. No.
Yeah.
Next question comes from the tower skin.
Oh, yeah. This guy is a crazy looking man.
This guy is chill as fuck, man.
He's cool. Yeah.
He was just jamming out, having a good ass time, man.
I saw him.
I would have a drink with that guy.
I saw him working out with one of them Iron Chic weight clubs and smoking a cigarette at the same time, and I was like, "That's really a crazy man." Yeah,
so he's fucking cool here. So we have a cool fan here. So we really got to impress this one.
We've certainly still got him listening at this point. This might be the babe that I want in quarantine with me.
He's blonde. It's a bombshell.
He's a blonde bimbo bombshell. He's a strong man.
Yeah. Hey, he's taking this serious because he has emoji. He's got a little face mask, so I'm glad.
Yeah, hey, he's going to survive. He can go get us supplies.
Mm-hmm.
Get me some more gin and tonics, Tower Skin.
I'll try this gin stuff. I will try it. I can't make any promises. What else is it mixed with? Can I mix it with, like, some Coca-Cola?
Fuck all. No, it'll be so gross with anything else. You know those little trees? They look kind of like pine trees, but they've got tiny little white hard things off of them. Instead, it's like cypress trees or whatever.
I'm mixing this with dirt and trees? What the fuck are you on here?
You know a cypress tree? Do those... Are you familiar with them?
No.
They, down the, out in the bogs, they have the cypresses out in the Okefenokee. Well, my brother, they taste a lot like a cypress tree is all I can tell you.
Okay, so it's healthy. So what Alex... At Tower Skin. At the Tower Skin. Alex,
the
Alex
Tower Skin.
Mr. Worldwide.
Yeah.
Are you guys like rationing... Yes, like Pitbull.
Are we rationing?
Are you guys rationing deodorant yet? So I'm deodorant. Some days I'm not wearing it, and that's a shoe.
Yeah.
Some days I'm not wearing it. You know, I took a shower. I'm good. That's it.
Yeah.
I'm not meeting anybody else. I'm good. Also, what about you? Are you wearing deodorant? You kind of have.
A little bit. I have to because I've got a. Sweatiness disease. I'm an Italian man.
Yeah, but Italian, so you do.
But
you do perspire.
Not as much as usual though, because I ain't getting into the gymnasium like I used to.
You're not doing those Iron Sheik exercises.
No, I don't have one of those Iron Sheik clubs, my brother. If I did, I'd be swinging it around left and right, and you know that. Everyone knows that about me.
There's a thing in ECW where they try to get a fan to do it, and that fan was gonna fuck himself up trying. And like, you know what? No, stop. Stop. Don't do it.
That shit looks hard, man.
Yeah,
I think
fuck with
that's
that.
A... Yeah, so, that's...
He's also
But I'm not allowed to have clubs. Oh, excellent.
Also, gun to your head, the gun is named Starvation 2 to 6 weeks from now. Would you rather eat cat or dog? It's a tough question.
Yeah. Well, you know,
I'm not thrilled. I love both. I have cats. I have dogs.
Yeah, I think a dog probably tastes better than a cat.
I mean, you're
right?
Talking meatier shit, bro. Like, I mean, obviously more is good.
Yeah.
You know, so...
Well, yeah.
I mean,
this
it's
is
not
survival.
Ideal.
No offense, dog, but...
Yeah, I mean, look, it's more. I don't... If cats...
It's almost a compliment to say I would rather eat a dog than a
cat. It's just a matter... Actually, it's more like, you know what? There's more
science.
Of this. What if cat's like a delicacy? But there's so little of it, though.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's like why wings are so much better than, you know, there's Buffalo Wild Wings, but there's no Buffalo Wild Breast.
If only.
Because they're bigger.
Bigger breasts? It's always a good thing for Uncle Howard. Wow, pervert.
If you've ever been to Buffalo, New York, you'll know there's no shortage of wild breasts there.
Our fans in Buffalo, sound off in the comments. Please.
Wealth, right?
Lives Wealth right is a Buffalo boy. Yeah. That man is the only person who I can confirm right now is drunker than me for sure, guaranteed.
Yeah.
I hate when he's smart. I hate so much that he's smart. It bothers me so much.
I've got a plan to take care of that.
Good. Make him dumb again. For the love of fucking
yeah,
God.
We're gonna hit him over the head.
Fix him like Moses Lack.
Biggie
A. Bryant, long time, he's a smart man.
Yeah.
He's the original dad.
The
real
dad. The originator.
The original.
Yeah.
He's the guy who started becoming a dad. What are your sleep settings on your sleep number mattress? Oh, boy.
69.
We had the joke. I was going to prep it and say 6, and I was hoping you'd say 9. I had a whole thing in my head. So we need to go over these. So sleep number mattress. So I've never been to sleep number mattress. I are they great? Do you know mattresses, Uncle Howard?
My brother, if I'm asleep, what do I care what it feels like?
Are you the kind of guy who sleeps anywhere, or are you like I need a bed?
I don't necessarily need a bed, but I can sleep incredibly well on an airplane for no particular reason.
I hate that. I hate it so much.
I don't even want to. It's just something about it knocks me out.
I hate it. I can't do it. I hate it. I hate sleeping. I mean, then I hate sleep. I love sleeping. I cannot sleep on an airplane. I am unable to do it. and I am annoyed because I see everybody else sleeping and they're having a great time, and I'm wide awake like Katy Perry.
I love that song.
You know she has a kitty. She has a cat. You know what the name of it is?
Yeah, I sure do.
Kitty Purry.
Kitty Purry.
That's a fact. A coworker told me that in 2012.
That's a fact, Jack.
It's a pillow promise.
That's right.
We do that. So, Handsome Brian, his handle is Bizrog. Bizrog.
Yeah, you think he's an orc from Lord of the Rings or something.
Those orcs. We never see an orc's dick. Fun fact.
Not in the director's cut, you do.
No. Well, funny thing about the director's cut, they're still not cut.
The director is cut, but the director's orcs cut. Are not.
The orcs are not.
Thank you for listening to our show, everybody.
Thank you. So, you know, we've had a fun time. We've had a great night, everybody. Fantastic show. A+.
Yeah.
Rate us on iTunes.
We've been tight tonight.
Great show. So sober. So good and smart.
All right.
Best Pluto TV channel is Bros Rock, Handsome Brian.
Brother, you know it's the AAA Lucha Libre channel.
Ooh, but it's all from 2004. I hate it.
Yeah, that's when it was even cooler. Nothing but Chessman, man.
Chessman. Yeah. I used to think his name was Cheese Man. That's another story for another time.
I know a good man.
Do you?
The Cheese Man? No. Yeah.
I do not.
I don't know Cheese Man, my brother.
So anyways, I'm looking through here. All right, Handsome Brian's a wrestling guy, though. Maybe he knows this from Virtual Pro. No. So
he's been around, man.
So Handsome Brian, fun fact here. I have tried some of the new White Claw flavors. I have tried the tangerine. I'm drinking a watermelon right now. They're fantastic. They're good. They're good for you. I'm just looking through your page right now. I'm sorry. I'm being a creep. He likes the Usos quite a bit. I like them too. They got haircuts.
This question I thought I would look up and then I did it. It's from Eli Hodap. He says, what is the boat equivalent of a Miata? That's a great question. I don't know a lot about boats, so I'm just going to look up like coolest speedboat ever, and that'll be a one-to-one equivalent with a Miata. It's called the Spirit of Australia. Mm-hmm. It went 317 miles per hour.
So,
but that's not a brand. That was one that someone just made to go the fastest ever. I gotta find like a brand bitch boat. Triple B.
Yeah, so there was a boat in Bayside. Miami. It's a mall, Bayside. It's an outdoor mall. Very, you know, you get some daiquiris there. There's like a mojito bar. It's pretty chill actually. Me and the Bugbane used to frequent it quite a bit. That used to be our spot. There's a Hall of Fame. But on that end Bayside, there's a yellow speedboat called the Thriller. Now you go on that Thriller, that is the Miata of boats because it's one of the coolest, it's one of the fastest. I bet Donald Trump would go on that Thriller boat, actually. He would love it.
It's the greatest boat. I think I found my ideal boat. It's called the AMG Project 151, and it's made with... There's a company called Cigarette. They make boats, apparently. That's pretty cool. So, Cigarette Racing Team and Mercedes AMG made a boat to match the latest Mercedes AMG supercar. So this car, or this boat, rather, It looks like you could crash it through Dormammu's head and it would hurt him and not you.
Fuck.
It's pretty crazy looking. I'm trying to find out how fast this bad boy goes because it is neat. The second place boat, they say, has a top speed of 122 miles per hour, which I feel like is very fast for a boat because they bounce around a lot, don't they? You ever ridden a jet ski, my brother? I guess you haven't, but I sure have. And boy, oh boy, jet ski. Well, Sleeves can tell you all about this. They bounce and bounce. It's like riding on a bucking bronco. And that's something I know more about. I once took a bronco out into a Ford Bronco, that is. I took it out onto a Lake Champlain, and I taught everybody some Lake Champagne for my sham friends and real pain for my real friends. Because that's the opposite of how it usually goes, but I teach people the arts of war.
What question are we on? Well, I'm sorry, I had to step out for a moment.
I know, you had to get... you had to fight with somebody out there.
Oh, yeah. Ruffians out there.
Oh, yeah. There's marauders coming through trying to steal our supplies.
Well, it turns out it was just a rave, actually.
Yeah, it was a moving rave. It was the Rosebuds were here.
The Rosebuds were here. I can't stand those Rosebuds in your party bus. I cannot stand them. Get a job. I can't stand them.
Here's a question from Don Knott's Thoughts.
Is he a firstie?
I think he might be a firstie, but I don't have. I've got to just.
He's definitely.
This question's asked and answered. Yeah, for sure. He says Carl Winslow or Danny Tanner.
That's
I'm
an
a
easy
Tanner
one.
Man. You're yeah, he's so horny.
Stop this shit right now.
He's so horny, man.
No. I know the Bay Area's biggest bachelor, Danny Tanner, is horny.
Yeah, wake up, San Francisco.
Wake up and get horny is really essentially, hey, who's going to be your co-host? Oh, I don't know. Just one of the fucking hottest people to fucking bribe a college in history. No big deal.
Yeah.
William
no
Macy.
No big deal to me. And I'll just let my own uncle marry her.
One of the hottest things he can do. Yeah. I'll just be, she'll live under my roof, but you know, let my uncle handle yeah. those porking duties. But no, Carl Winslow at the end of the day,
is a family man.
He's a family man. Family
he's
matters.
A fucking cop, my brother.
Oh, well, see, I'm not too enthusiastic about that profession he chose, you know, but look,
maybe that life chose him. We don't know that.
And look, Harriet was operating an elevator for the perfect strangers.
That's true.
She was. This is a fact. She was an elevator operator for the perfect strangers. This guy needed a job. Lord knows it's not easy to get steady work out there, and unfortunately he picked a profession that's not the best, but you know, you get to take the money from the drug dealers. That's kind of okay.
Yeah, you take from the rich and you give to the poor.
Look, he supported that Urkel kid for fucking sure. So
yeah,
Carl Winslow.
How much of their food do you think Urkel ate?
Now Urkel wasn't a Steve from Full House, the voice of Aladdin. Urkel, the voice of Sonic, the cartoon. How can I be drunk if I'm able to correlate that, officer?
Yeah.
Impossible. So
would a drunk guy be that smart?
Would a drunk man be able to tell you Steve Urkel did the voice of Sonic, fans movie?
Yeah. A lot of people also don't know that the same guy who played Steve Urkel played Stefan Urkel.
See, less people know that because they're not as smart as us. But Carl Winslow is my pick, Don Knotts. He is emotionally intelligent. We see him grow. You know, he had a second Harriet. You know, why stop at one? He was smart.
Yeah.
You know?
That's right.
That's second Harriet. We don't
just
really talk about
thought
it much.
You had all the answers. He went and changed the culture. Favorite wrestler,
him.
Right?
I hate him so much. Sometimes I get red thinking about CM Punk.
Franklin, do you think you could beat up CM Punk in real life?
You know, I would love
I
to say yes.
I honestly think,
No.
I don't know that you could. I think you would stand a better chance against him than almost any other wrestler.
Thank you, for starters. Thank you. And a lot of people think, I would be a weakling in a fight. And yes, I would lose most fights, to be honest. However... Stephen A. Smith
style. You could
style.
Beat the yeah.
No.
You know no, I'm no. a weakling.
Now you know I am a coward. However, Max Kellerman, I would throw a little sand in the eye of Punk. I wouldn't mind grabbing the crotch. I would grab another man's crotch if it meant stealing victory for myself. Max Kellerman, you know a lot about boxing, but I know the most about crotch grabbing. And that's my area of expertise.
That's true. Well,
I would grab. What I'm trying to say is, would I win? Maybe not. I can't say for sure. I'd probably lose, but I would try dick things to try to get the upper hand. I would do groin stuff for sure, like George Costanza.
Yeah, you always got to go for the groin. If you're not groining, you ain't trying, my boy.
If you're a weakling, if you're a coward, if you cannot fight, your best option, the only option God has left you, is to go for that man's dick.
Yeah.
Plain and
simple. Smash. Franklin, you could also beat the shit out of Marco Stunt.
No. Marco Stunt, there wouldn't need to be anything, because Marco Stunt, I don't like. I'd be driven by an agenda that I do not like him. I don't care for the flossing. I think flossing's cool, except for him.
Yeah, I don't like the way he flosses, man.
I don't like
it's disrespectful to the style.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like his weird little butt.
It's disrespectful to the backpack kid, the inventor of the floss.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, what a jerk.
Marco Stunt. Enemy of the show.
Yeah, big time. Never welcome in the king size bed.
Next question comes from Alphabet Pizza.
AP, Advanced Placement.
That's damn smart. Would you rather have to drink all your beverages from a barrel or a tiny baby bottle? You know, this is the only question I thought about. I skim through these and I say, I hate these. I don't want to read these.
Insult me.
These, you know. But hers is the one I thought the most about. I'm not drinking Jim Beam here. I'm drinking soda pop. I'm drinking cold beverages. Neither a plastic container nor a barrel is ideal for my choice of beverage. But a baby bottle would be the way to go, because I'm not looking to carry around a big barrel here. You know, I'm not Billy the Kid.
Yeah, I don't think a baby bottle would be so bad. In many ways, I think it would help me pace myself.
That's so smart. If I had a drinking problem, which I don't.
Yeah, I know.
Why would I lie?
It doesn't make sense.
If I had a drinking problem, I wouldn't have a job, but I have a job.
Yeah, so do the math.
Do the math.
Dum-dums.
Yeah. So a baby bottle, and just suck them down, you know? See, it'd make me hornier, though. That's the problem.
Because you're a very sexy baby.
Yeah. Dirty Rock. Love it. I'm glad you caught up. I'm glad you finished, man.
I finished it now. I want to go back and watch it.
Might go back. It's on Hulu?
It's on Hulu.
Yeah. I hate him. All right.
I hate that guy.
I can't stand Hulu.
Yeah. Enemy of the show.
Vulgar Lasagna, again.
Oh, he's a good boy.
Why is he the only one who asks the smart questions, is my question.
Because he's the only guy who's got a brain in his damn head, my brother. You know that.
Do you ever hear strange noises when you're alone? Yes. Absolutely. And I suspect the worst to Vulgar Lasagna. I think aliens constantly. I thought this would go away after 20 years, but no. I still think aliens would want me, despite the fact that I'm not very intelligent life. It's almost egotistical of me. It's almost
you're
a reflection
easy,
of angel. Ego.
But you're easy taking that way.
Right? I am easy taking, but I do think aliens, I don't know, maybe, why? I think they would want me. Why wouldn't they want me?
Why don't you want me, man?
Why don't they? Uncle Phil.
Tragic. Franklin, there's something in the back room.
I don't like that song. It's scary. It scares the fuck out of me, man. I hope it's not those creatures.
From above.
Yeah.
It used to. Hey, you know, I never hear anything when I'm not around.
Really?
Never.
God. See? See, we're both self-absorbed in different ways. I'm self-absorbed because I think the aliens would take me. I'm like a top prospect. And you're self-absorbed because you don't even think about the aliens.
I don't worry about the aliens, brother, because they don't worry about me.
That's what you think. Next question.
Well, yeah. Let's keep it coming.
Sorry.
No. Let's see. Here's a question from, this one's for me. And I don't have time to go all the way into this one. It's from some star stuff. She said, can we get a timeline of Big Unk's relationship with Joe Exotic? And why wasn't Howard in the courtroom to support his pal?
You were, and people think, they're just joking. They do the thing. And it's fine. We do that. You were Facebook friends with Joe Exotic legitimately.
That's right.
Legitimately, that's right. Like everything else the show is. You were legitimately friends with him. I never really paid attention. You would show it to me and say, I don't care. Thanks, man. I mean, I wouldn't say that to you, but I'm nice.
Yeah. You were just like, oh, yeah, that's
good. Oh, he's weird. Okay, great. He was too weird yeah. for me, and I'm just like, oh, okay. I this didn't relate. It didn't resonate with me.
A lot of it went to the point of a certain darkness that wasn't really entertaining.
Yeah, that's so a problem. Yeah. Yeah,
yeah. yeah. It was like after his husband accidentally killed himself, and then he was just posting like "I love you" all the time on Facebook. Like that's not funny,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. Hey, make us laugh, dingus.
Yeah, yeah. Be a clown for us.
Yeah, be a clown on social media. What else? What else? Yeah. What else is the purpose of this site? But no.
Yeah. But yeah. Also, I mean, you know, I'm not just friends with him on Facebook. Of course, he and I, we used to go down to the Serengeti in Africa and lasso up some big cats
there
together.
We go.
Yeah. That's what you were looking for, right?
That's what you're looking. You ever see Monty Brown in the Serengeti?
Yeah. Pounce.
Period. This is what do we have? We have like 2 hours of podcast. We got like 2 hours of podcast, bro. Yeah, we're gonna finish in 2 hours. I spoke to you. I said, "Do you want to do 1 hour?" You said, "No, I don't care. Let it flow naturally." The problem is we haven't spoken to each other much lately, so we've been catching up and we've been doing this. And I mean, if you're doing 2 hours, bless your fucking heart, man.
You know what? We need to set aside 30 minutes every day to just catch up with
we
each other.
We know what? We need... But you see, but we're too... We need to set aside some off-air time.
Yeah.
I agree.
Well, because we don't like... We've been fighting in real life.
We put aside our differences. We do this show.
We're not on speaking terms.
We're not on speaking terms for the majority of the week.
But then we record the show, and we're on speaking terms, and we realize, you know, oh, I got to catch up with this guy because I've been so pissed off at him. I don't know what he's been doing lately.
Yeah, yeah. By the way, yeah. Stone Cold, not happy with you.
Nah, well, that's right. Yeah. I forgot. Yeah, well, you know, he better look out because I bet I can run away before he even finds out where I am, and then he'll look pretty dumb coming here.
We talk a lot about fighting. We talk a lot about being cowards.
Yeah.
The Stone Cold is not a fucking person.
Yeah. Hey, Stone Cold is he's a person to fight as long as it's someone else doing the fighting.
Agree.
That's why I thought you could drive the Miata dressed like me.
Oh, how nice of you. What a nice gesture of no alternative motives.
Drive around the Broken Skull Ranch and just, you know, holler.
Do donuts around
fool.
It?
Yeah, do donuts around it. Maybe, like, find some old cactuses that are growing there that look really tall and impressive and cut them down with a chainsaw. Stuff
piss
like that.
Piss on them.
Yeah, piss on them. Write "beer sucks" on his front door.
Now, I wouldn't say that because you know who loves beer?
Who?
Oh, no. Well, he lives across the street from this beer member. It's just... His enthusiasm for beer.
I love beer.
Oh, that's a good impersonation.
Thanks. Yeah, so, we don't want him over here.
No, we don't want him over here. That family. I can't stand it.
Yeah. I got friends, not family.
Yeah, I don't like that family.
This is a new question. A new guy, new asker. He's a wrestling guy, I think, but he's asking us a question with respect. It's at @son_oon.
I don't... we got a lot of questions. We're going to finish these.
Yeah. We don't have to answer all of them. This will be the last one.
No. We got a couple more I want to answer. But
okay. Got a couple more I got to answer. Yeah. Respect for the famiglia. So he says, as top tier bed guys, thank you, As top tier bed guys, are you excited to finally have some representation amongst the fat cats in Washington, the swamp, with American bed lord Mike Lindell of MyPillow making a completely appropriate statement at the White House COVID-19 task force briefing yesterday?
Yeah, that guy's definitely aces right there, huh?
Yeah, he's definitely a smart guy.
Yeah. So Stone Cold Steve Austin, you're asking a great question. Mike Lindell, he showed up. Now, if you're that enthusiastic about pillows, is it grotesque for me to assume that is he making pillows to fuck eventually? Is my question to you, Uncle Howard.
Is he making fuck pillows?
Is he making... No. Does it evolve into... I know this guy, Mike Lindell...
He makes some of the least erotic pillows I've ever seen.
He does. He does. That's true. So you're not talking about pillows to hump.
No, these pillows are disgusting.
Yeah. He shows up a lot on our Pluto TV ads.
Yeah, they say, I sleep better too. I knew you would.
Yeah, I can't stand it. And yeah, he's a God-fearing man.
Yeah. He knew you'd sleep better on his pillow, but he didn't know about 9/11 before it happened. This guy's a fraud.
I don't know. Okay. Well, yeah. That's a good point. It's a great counterpoint.
Because
there.
In your dreams, you see the future.
Oh, that's right. That's right. If these my pillows are so good, why doesn't Dormammu use them?
Yeah, maybe he'd be an easygoing guy for once.
This, you know... I don't feel like he is a representation of, you know, I don't think he's a bed guy necessarily. I think he's a creep who's exploiting the bed guy market here. You know, I think he's exploiting poor people who love a good night's sleep or his shitty ass pillows. I don't sanction the buffoonery of Mike Lindell, to be honest. The more I think about it, I'm getting a little heated. I'm getting a little red.
Yeah, I don't like him either. He goes around telling everybody, like, what their business is. When last I checked, if he was a smart guy, he'd be running Amazon.com instead of MyPillow.com.
Yeah, you know what?
Fuck off, Mike Lindell.
Mike Lindell, you go on stage, you do your little speech, and that's all well and good.
All funny, good, cute stuff, whatever.
Mike Lindell, you go on the stage, you talk about your Psalms, your John 3:16. Well, Austin 3:16 means I just beat your ass.
Yes, right, Mike Lindell.
And Owen 3:16 means something way worse, man.
My Clindell.
What is that?
There's something for you.
My Clit Lindell. Is that what you're doing here?
That was disgusting. That was disgusting.
That was disgusting because I'm trying to figure out what disgusting shit you're trying to say, you pervert. You porno pervert.
That must mean I'm disgusting.
Great artist. Great.
M and M. And
so we got a question here.
Yeah.
Teach.
Do we?
Yo, Teach. He's asking, since Roman Reigns cannot face Goldberg at WrestleMania. Well, they did advertise on a Monday Night Raw.
I love Reigns.
Well, not Reigns member. We don't know if he's talking about Roman Luther or the Body Fuel, but.
Oh, Luther Reigns, great wrestler.
Why don't they just have Rain Body Fuel face him instead? Rain would win. I mean, Goldberg's a old, beat-up sack of meat. Are you watching WrestleMania, Uncle Howard?
Yeah, fuck yeah, man, it's free.
Dude, WrestleMania, it's fucking cool as hell. It's dope. You're telling me you're not going to watch it? I don't know who you're trying to fuck.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know who you're trying to impress, but, like, I'm...
But it ain't one of the unks, that's for sure.
You're trying to fuck one of us, buddy. If you're telling me you're not watching the show of... The Showdown of the Immortals. Kelsey Grammer narrated a WrestleMania. How could you not be excited?
One time Bobby the Brain Heenan wore a toga.
That's cool.
Yeah.
He wore a toga and some undies. Well, he's not going to be naked under there, I guess. Like, you know.
He could have been. If it's in Las Vegas, baby, it's Vegas, hot.
So, I don't know. I mean, I don't know who Goldberg's opponent is going to be. Will it be a Spartan who drinks Rain Body Fuel? Will it be Luther Reigns? I don't know. Will it be Rain on Me? An action in that movie?
It might just be Uncle freaking Howard.
Uncle Howard. Do you have WrestleMania spoilers to spare?
I do.
Oh.
Let's just say the 10 pounds of gold comes back to the king's husband.
Well, that's good to know. Anyways, Uncle Howard, we've answered some questions. They've been fantastic.
We have. Have they?
Sure. Let's take a little break, if you don't mind.
No, a breather.
I'll take a breather here, because I've been drinking so many of these. I gotta go.
You've been drinking some Red Claws.
Yeah,
White. Red Claws, a White Claw with a Red Bull mixer.
Ooh, I like that. All right, be right
back. Yeah, daddy likey. There goes Franklin. Well, folks, with Franklin out of the picture, I can finally tell you what my ultimate goal for this podcast is. Number one, kill Franklin. There is no number two. This girl that I went to high school with once had on all of her social medias a quote from Busta Rhymes, allegedly, that said, "All of my success I owe to the fact that I had no plan B." Well, I've got no plan B either, Franklin. And your ass is grass, Jack. Hey, how's everybody out there doing? Why are you still listening to this show? It's been almost 2 hours, an hour and 44. But to be fair, I think we are going to cut out about 5 minutes. No one ever said we don't edit the show. And if they did, they'd be a damn truth teller. And there's nothing worse than someone who tells the truth. That's a dirty snitch where I come from. Oh, Howard didn't do the stuff he was supposed to. Oh, Howard's making it so everyone else's job is harder because he's bad at his job. Grow up, snitch. Hey there, Franklin.
Yeah.
Welcome back.
Well, you know, these white claws make me piss. I'm not
gonna lie. Yeah, you should drink some pretzels. They'll soak up some of the piss.
Oh, man. See, you're a science guy. That's what I love about you.
Yeah, that's what they call me. Bill Nighy, the British actor.
Oh, man. So, wait a second. Okay. I thought you were in the chat while we were doing the show, but I'm glad it's an old message.
I would never chat, my brother.
No. Because I got a notification on my phone here.
I only do voice to text.
Right. Do you really?
Yeah. No, but what if I did?
That'd be great.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. I might start. Typing sucks.
I hate it.
You like it?
No.
No one likes it. Ugh.
Why do we have to do that shit? It gets wrong. Yeah. It's wrong when you try fucking doing voice text, though.
Yeah, well, everything's wrong. Maybe the only thing that's right these days is just us cool old unks talking our stories.
So... Well, speaking of stories, we could wheel out Uncle Ronald, but we won't. No. So, I got some questions here. I do want to do some topics. I know we've been going long.
Yeah.
We've been going real long, and that's fine. Yeah. We've been going.
Call us a Hail Mary, because you're going long, baby.
Yeah. That's right. Football. Who is Caroline Calloway? I don't know who Caroline Calloway is, and she's been... popping up on my notifications, my feed.
Caroline.
What's the scoop
Caroline
on her?
Caroline Calloway. Well, I'm glad you asked because I'm an expert. Caroline Calloway, first of all, her main problem is I think she's from New York City.
There it is.
If you're not a Gotti, a Trump, or a Cloverfield, you're probably not a friend of mine if you're from New York City. Now, with that in mind, yeah, I love that Cloverfield
he's
guy.
He's a good guy. Yeah, he's chill.
Well, he blew up Lizzie Kaplan, which was an issue.
That wasn't cool, but he did pop in during a county fair at the end.
Yeah, he sure did.
Just popped in.
And yeah, and you know what? When you mess with New York, you mess with all of them.
That didn't work out that well, regardless.
Yeah. So Caroline Calloway, I think she was an influencer. She would go on Instagram and say, "Yeah, here I am in Budapest," and there she would be, just, you know. I don't know that she was in Budapest during the same time that Hawkeye and Black Widow were there.
God, but... you're good with that shit, bro. You're like the number one guy, and you're what makes me realize I love these movies. And I do love these movies. I've seen them all. It's not like I go to them because you're telling me to. I see them all, and I love them. But yeah,
but no one loves them more than me.
You love them, and your love is infectious. Because now, what happened to Budapest? Well, I don't know. You know, there's so much those Marvel movies. We're just fans of Marvel movies, aren't we? The best movies ever made.
They're smart.
They're smart.
They tell a story.
They do that.
Yeah, and that's really cool.
I love that.
And, I mean, you know, a lot of movies, they just are like, here's the movie, whatever. The Marvel movies, they say something like, this guy, he might be a cool superhero guy, but also he's got some jokes.
Mm-hmm.
Or
that's cool.
Maybe he's sad a little bit about something. Maybe he's got a girlfriend who died in the past. All sorts of stuff. They're good movies, man. So, Caroline Calloway, she was there in New York City when the Chitauri invaded. And she
live streamed during that?
Yeah, she was live streaming. And cool. She was doing a bunch of Instagram stories. And,
you know, I'm not much of a reader. Well, I don't know. Do Instagram stories count as reading?
Are there words? Then yeah.
That's,
come on,
sometimes.
Everybody's so, you know, critical about this stuff. Oh, you don't read books. Okay, maybe I don't. But I read almost every single billboard that I drive past.
That's thank you for that. You know, people work hard and put those billboards up there for you to read.
It's not just disrespectful. It's despectful.
It's despectful.
Not to read
I can't stand. I see a billboard. Oh, wait a second. I want to see all those details. I want to slow down. I'm going to slow down my driving on this highway. I want to see. I need to read all this. You know.
I think that I shall always see a billboard lovely as a tree.
You know what? In 2012, there's always a WrestleMania billboard up, and I loved it so much. I was like, yes! Those are the wrestlers. Those are my friends!
The toughest guys in all the land.
You know, to see John Cena on a billboard on I-95, you can't, you know, it's like, now everybody knows who he is. It's not just my secret. Now everybody knows who John Cena is.
I bet you threw a salute at him like you were one of
the Marines.
Right.
I don't condone the Marines. I think they're kind of shrimps, to be honest.
Yeah, and if they got a problem with that, they can find me down at the Broken Skull Ranch in Texas.
That's right. Yeah, they can come find me there. Yeah, Steve.
My name is Steve. I
can't stand
ask
me.
For a drink of my beer. I really like it.
Yeah. Over at the El Segundo. Anyways.
Yeah, Broken Skull IPA.
Oh, is that what it's called? Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
So Caroline Calloway,
she was an influencer. She was going to Budapest, whatever. And then it turned out that she wasn't even writing her own Instagram captions, which all just said stuff like, so blessed to be here in Budapest. She wasn't even doing that. And she got a book deal out of it.
That's cool.
And then it turned out...
I don't like books, but that's cool.
Well, I mean, good for her, except that it turned out she wasn't writing any of even her own Instagrams, and so
is that
a
crime?
Apparently, if you sign a contract, a little bit it is.
Ooh.
I love crime.
Not crime member. Hey, crime member. No, that's too
crime,
many. Get the fuck out of here.
Crime me
friend.
A river.
Oh God. Alliteration humor too, huh, crime member? You're the smarter one of the fucking family tree.
Because there's nothing smarter than crime.
There is nothing smarter than crime.
Yeah, they always say crime pays. That's why people do it.
I fucking love it.
Yeah. Anyway, the gal who is writing all her stories said, hey, I'm the one who's writing all of Caroline Calloway's Instagram stories, like a little snitch.
Okay.
But then
that's
Caroline
whack.
Calloway,
I don't like snitches. I don't like that.
Yeah, but you know what? I don't like fakers either. I don't like posers. I don't like new jacks.
Hold up. This Caroline Calloway, I don't know anything.
Yeah.
She took some shortcuts, which I like.
Sure.
I like shortcuts. Those are cool.
Why would you go the long way?
Why would you go the long way? No, I want to take the long way to 7-Eleven. No. Hell no. You know, I want a shortcut. We all love shortcuts. And it sounded like there was a snitch situation. It sounded like she wasn't in Budapest. Well, I don't need to be in Budapest. I could watch a couple of videos on YouTube.com. So it's like being there anyways. It sounds like she did nothing wrong and is being unfairly persecuted. And I hate to say this. I hate to sound like Jack. By mostly the liberal media. I don't know. Am I wrong?
You and I remember Budapest very differently.
Goddamn your Marvel fucking history, man. You are so good.
I remember little random lines from throughout the film.
God, and I remember them too.
And now she's on Twitter, and I believe Rich is really trying to attract her notice for probably wants to read the Bible with her or something respectful like that.
Probably. Yeah. Imagine that. I imagine as much. Rich, Godspeed via Con Dios. Next topic here. I had a list. I lost it.
I think I remember. We wanted to check in with our friends, the celebs, again.
How are the celebrities doing right now?
I love celebs!
Oh, that celeb member. Oh, boy. Oh, boy, this guy.
Chris Hemsworth and a pipe.
What's that?
Nothing. He got out of here.
Piper Perabell?
I choked him within an inch of his life.
Well, you know, sayonara, celeb member. So far we've had drug member, celeb member, scrubs member. Pop in. Scrubs member. He didn't say much, but he was here. You know,
I think fans member.
Fans
was
member
here,
was
right?
Bizarre because he likes our fans, and that's just dumb. Like, okay.
At least someone does.
I mean, somebody has to, but it ain't gonna be us. Yeah. Funny. There's no virtual member for virtual pros. They don't have that.
Let's try to call virtual pros member out here. Cricket sound.
See if I knew editing, I would do that.
We don't need editing. That's come on, man. You're trying to win best audio effects at the Supreme Oscar Awards?
Yeah, good point here. So the celebrities, how are they doing? We're reaching the 2-hour mark, and Uncle to Uncle second.
But that's why we're finishing up with the biggest stars of all.
Let's see what are the celebrities of. Is Louis? No, he's not on Twitter anymore.
Oh man, why not?
Great question.
Yeah, let's see what he's up to. All right, I'm checking out a very funny man, a man by the name of Chris Kattan.
What's Chris Kattan up to?
His Twitter sucks. It's just Instagram posts where he uses a lot of hashtags, and it says, like, I went to the store, hashtag coronavirus, hashtag isolation.
Oh my god.
This guy. You suck, Chris Kattan. Chris Kattan's Instagram
sucks. Don't touch the face. Wash your hands. Hashtag coronavirus, and it's his Instagram. You know, he's an Instagrammer. That's what he is. He doesn't do Twitter.
Yeah, you don't do Twitter, my brother.
What? Oh no, I don't do Twitter, my brother.
Uncle Ronald is
there. No! I'm watching my stories. Hey. Why are all the gold members crossing the street and coming on our house? I'm trying to watch my stories.
You know, Chris Kattan doesn't even follow cool people. He just follows
a bunch of... He fucking sucks, man. Oh, man. I can't believe I wanted him on the show.
He follows the Mohegan Sun.
I gotta follow the arena the Phoenix Suns play. I gotta follow the arena, the Phoenix Suns playing, to see if I can get it half off on fucking drinks here. How does he follow the Moe? Okay. He follows the last OG on TBS. Fine show. Cool. Terrific. Why are you following them, dude? They're a show. He follows
Rand McNally, the maps people.
He follows Palm Beach downtown. West Palm Beach. Not a fucking happening downtown.
Well, that's cool.
No, it's not that. Fuck you. Me and Bugman did a little Palm Beaching not too long ago. The Blue Martini, no big deal. But he follows the Palm Beach Improv and the Palm Beach Downtown. So he follows two West Palm Beach accounts. And he follows Duquesne Women's Basketball, Duquesne University Women's Basketball, and Atlantic 10 Conference. No, that is cool.
He might be the only person in the entire world who follows both Ivanka Trump and Lisa Loeb.
He follows Comedy Universe.
He follows Amy Smart.
Well, that I can get by.
That makes sense to me, brother.
He follows Joe Biden.
Uh-oh. But then he also follows Mike Pence. What is this guy up to?
He follows Piper Perabo.
And Johnny Weir.
That's... Man, yeah, you're right. Just follow Ivanka Trump, Kerry Washington, Lisa Loeb. Man, Stephen King, LeVar Burton. Chris Kattan, what's wrong with you?
He follows the U.S. Coast Guard and the Keck Medical School of USC.
He follows so many blue check... He follows It Chapter 2. Now, what does Chapter 2 have to offer you that I do not? It's on Blu-ray and digital. Congratulations, Chris Kattan. Why in the world are you following It Chapter 2 that hasn't updated since February?
Oh, he follows Johnny Legs. Now, that's smart.
Well, no, no,
he follows...
Chris Kattan, what the fuck are you doing?
I'm almost tempted to say I don't think we can do better than Chris Kattan's follow list. You follow so many people, Jesus Christ. You follow Simone Biles, and then...
He follows John Lovett, the bad one that Jack doesn't like.
He follows a lot of guys who the first word in their bio is CEO of something or other.
He follows the Weather Channel, and he also follows the National Weather Service. He loves the weather.
He follows Tayson Day of Chocolate Rain fame.
Man.
Yeah, he follows a bunch of weather guys. I'm in the weather stretch. It's
the weather. Check this out. I'm looking up weather right now.
Dr. Greg Forbes, severe weather expert at the Weather Channel. Mike Betts, official Twitter for Weather Channel meteorologist. Mike Betts, Jin Carfagno, meteorologist of the Weather Channel. What is this guy's problem?
Chris Kattan. He follows none but blue check. He follow Lo Bosworth. Do you know who Lo Bosworth is? You might not know. Might not know. Lo Bosworth, if I am correct here, she was on Laguna Beach. Lo Bosworth. Yes, he follows Laguna Beach's own Lo Bosworth, who is also in Jeepers Creepers 3. All because, I don't know why. Why is he following Low from fucking Laguna Beach, Chris Kattan? You have a lot to answer. Look, I love Low. I'm not Low member. I love Low.
Low member is getting more and more obscure.
You don't know Laguna Beach. You didn't watch Laguna Beach, man. The fuck's wrong with you? It's a good show.
Because I lived it, man. I lived Laguna Beach life.
Let the rain fall down, man.
Yeah, he follow. You know that movie Arrival? He follows not just the U.S. movie release of Arrival, but the U.K. release of Arrival Twitter account.
Chris Kattan, hold on a minute. Why are you watching?
Follows Spencer Pratt's sister.
Heidi Pratt? No, Heidi's his wife. Yeah. What's Spencer Pratt's sister name?
Fuck, man, I gotta go back and find it. Stephanie Pratt.
Stephanie Pratt. Now, she was something
related
of...
Related to Chris Pratt.
She was something of a villain. Not a villain. Wait. He follows all the fucking Laguna Beach people, man. Whitney Port, that's from the Hills. Lo Bosworth, yeah. Lauren Conrad.
Elsie, yeah.
Holly Madison is Girls Next Door. Okay.
Yeah.
He follows Kendra Wilkinson... From Girls Next Door.
Kendrick Lamar from Girls Next Door.
God, that's my favorite. So basically, Chris Kattan, I don't even know. What's your following deal, man? Who was the first person he followed on Twitter? Is what I'm gonna scroll down. I'm scrolling to the depths,
Going all the way.
I'm going down, man.
He follows the official SpongeBob.
I saw that just
Patrick
now.
The starfish.
I saw that just now.
This guy makes me sick. He sicks me out.
He does. I don't. You know what? I started this episode a Chris Kattan fan, and
I'm ending it. An enemy.
He follows the World Bank. I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, it sounds bad. He follows... Oh, man, you and I are, like, right on the same spots all along.
Mm-hmm.
Well, because we're looking at the same computer.
That's right. Why else would we not be... You know, are people... Yeah. People may not be entertained.
He follows the SVU writer's room. Why wouldn't you be entertained?
Why wouldn't you... He follows Aerosmith.
Oh, man, that's a callback to our own show.
Hey! Yeah, we talked about Aerosmith. Space
Aerosmith.
Lisa Vanderpump.
He follows Paul F. Tompkins.
Ethan Salt.
Oh, he follows my most hated enemy ever, Don Cheadle.
Should I just cut this segment out and put it on like Twitter?
No.
Paris? He follows Hilton. Paris Hilton.
Let's put this on OnlyFans.
Mario Lopez. He follows Mario.
All right. I've had it.
I can't go down anymore. How many people does he follow? 5,000?
Yeah.
Okay, you know what?
Who is this guy?
Chris Kattan.
Follows don't mean anything to him, as far as I can tell.
Chris Kattan. There's a famous line from Sucker Punch, a movie you've seen.
Yeah.
There's a line. I don't remember because I've had a few. I'm not going to lie today, everybody. It says, if you follow anybody, you'll fall for anything. Remember what was that line? It's in the trailer. I've never seen Sucker Punch. You know the line I'm talking about?
I can't recall.
Is it if you follow anybody, you'll fall for anything? It's something like that, man. The general.
Oh, yeah, if you won't stand for anything, you'll fall for everything.
Okay, see, that's what I was waiting for. See, that's why you're my partner.
Well, I'm also here to tell you something else. Scott Bayo is, you know, this is
Bayo?
A very stressful time for a lot of people. Bayo, tomato, tomato.
Scott Bayo.
He's renovating his kitchen. And somebody replied to him and they said, come on, Scott, it's cool you're able to get a new kitchen. You work hard. It's your timing, rather. Mm-hmm. People are suffering with no work or just supporting their families. Maybe think some people can barely keep food in the kitchen. Everyone has a perspective. Kind of a bird brain way to say it, but I know what she's saying. Mm-hmm. She's saying, don't brag about your wealth when people are suffering right now.
Right.
Scott Bayo. He says, we started this in mid-January. The cabinet maker, the slab fabricator, and the floor guy are already out of pocket for their supplies and labor. Therefore, we are moving forward to help them get this done so they get paid. All small bus owners. Why are so many people rude? I don't think she was rude.
Yeah, I don't think she was rude either. I think Scott Bayo is a piece of shit.
Yeah, you know what? If Scott Bayo, if I wasn't afraid of getting my account deleted, I'd say, shit, dummy.
I'm not afraid of getting my account. I'll tell them you shit right now.
Yeah, all right, I will too, my brother. Fuck this guy.
Yeah, I'll tell him right now. Eat shit, Scott Bayo. Yeah, you're listening to a...
Yeah, you're listening to this live tweeting at Scott Bayo telling him to eat shit, motherfucker.
His Twitter handle is Scott Bayo. Okay, eat shit.
Yeah. He'll
never live
that
one down. Oh, that's
vulgar,
though. I don't know. Am I going to get in trouble?
No, it's okay, man. Man, it...
I did it. I tweeted it.
Nothing matters anymore.
I tweeted it.
It's 2020, brother. We about to have President Bloomberg in the house.
That's right. We called it.
Now,
we called it all along. Did you do it?
Yeah, I did. I called him a motherfucker, too.
Because I said, eat shit.
Scott Bakula, now this is another Scott, a Scott B.A., who's got a good attitude. And he says, in his most recent one, hope everyone is staying home to watch the newest episode of NCIS CBS. Yeah, that's a class act, brother. He's saying there's a pandemic going on out there. Don't waste your time breathing in all those virus lungs. You just stay home and enjoy yourself with some NCIS New Orleans. Now that's cool, right?
Mm. You know I don't like NCIS.
Oh, yeah, but New Orleans, brother.
Oh, the Big Easy, huh?
The Big Easy.
Mm.
Port of Call, Bad Lieutenant.
Big Easy, one of my favorite The Challenge people.
Yeah, good rapper, probably.
Well, no. I think he was a fat guy
Big
who couldn't
Easy.
Complete one of the challenges. And they gave him a lot of shit for it, actually. But
That's not nice.
No, well.
A lot of people out there are rude, not like us.
No, we're pretty nice guys, actually. I think this episode comes... I think we're pretty nice, pretty sober, we're pretty good.
Yeah.
Wait. Why is Scott Baio's bio says, I was falsely accused by a fake Me Too liar on Facebook. What a fucking bio.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was intending to Google when I first ended up on your page, you piece of shit hack. Who are some other notable Hollywood conservatives? Let's see what they're up to.
What's John Voight up to?
I bet that guy definitely writes his own tweets.
he knows how to use the internet so good. Hey, to his credit, he's following 8 people. He's not fucking... He's fucking...
Oh, yeah, he's not fucking around, man. And he also hasn't tweeted in a couple of weeks. He's
Scott,
respectful.
Oh, boy.
He's following Scott Baio.
He's following Scott Baio, though.
Oh, he's following James Woods, yeah.
and Sean Hannity, yeah.
God, what a... Ugh.
We will win. What, oh, if, God, he sucks. Say the truth.
You know what? Why would you even... Even if you were a conservative person, why would you ever talk about it? It's so dumb seeming. I'd be so ashamed of it if I was conservative. If I'd be like, oh, no, I'm totally Bernie guy. Yeah. You'd be like, well, how come this guy says he's voting for Bernie or he knows about Venezuela or whatever? He doesn't know anything about it. And
unlike us.
Yeah, unlike us.
So... Uncle Howard,
we're not conservatives,
we've reached the 2-hour mark of this episode. We've passed it, actually.
Oh, yeah,
the longest podcast in history. You wanted to do 24 hours. I gave you 2.
I, brother, we could do it so easy, man.
No,
once we get going,
listen. Nobody would listen past this fucking point. I'm shocked anybody's still here with us. If they are,
your inflection was very Trumpian right then.
Well, I need to appeal to the smartest demographic imaginable.
I don't know who would listen.
The new hoax. The new hoax.
And that's how we do Trump. We just figured out how to do the voice.
We just figured it out. Nice.
We just figured it out. Okay, it was very hard to do.
It's good. You got a good Trump going right now. Fuck.
You got a good Trump. Why do we have to end the show? I got a good Trump.
You got a good Trump going here.
I'm just going to ride it out into the rest of the night. Folks, you can find... What? Fuck, Rich. Should we even do plugs at this point?
No,
this is
a long episode. Get us on Patreon. You can find us at Uncle to Uncle. You know who we are. At BugTV Franklin. He's at MiataGuy4. That's the number. The letter U. MiataGuy4U on Twitter. He's hilarious. One of the best. One of the best follows. One of the best.
One of the most luxurious Twitters.
Do we love our troops? How about our Miata drivers? MiataGuy4U, a real Miata driver. I'm like that Hodap character.
That's okay.
For everybody, yeah, that's fine. So for everybody donating to us on Patreon, God bless you. You are getting us through some tough times. We're buying plenty of Coca-Cola classics with that.
Yep.
But no, God bless your hearts. We will have some great content. Some of the finest for you. Everybody else, God bless. You know, we're gonna get through this together. This coronavirus, I can't stand it.
Yeah.
I'm anti-virus.
Yeah. Oh, just like McAfee.
McAfee. Everybody update your McAfee and you'll be just fine. Not really. I'm not Jericho. I'm not going to promote a false cure like Chris Jericho.
You know what?
Fraud.
We can't let the virus win, everybody.
It's not about the virus. It's about just us.
The vire-I.
Yes. If you're the virus listening to this episode, if you're the coronavirus... Oh, boy.
Oh, coronavirus. We gotta have a come to Jesus.
Go fuck yourself. All right. 3, 2, 1, stop. 3, 2, 1, stop.
Oh, stop is...